afternoon, everybody. Welcome to your terrific Tuesday afternoon Devo, the Daily Bread Passage. Episode 930, Part 2. Tuesday, December 13th, 2022. And this one we're going to be learning the meaning of life. From Ken Peterson. Derived from 1 Corinthians 15:50-58. So if you're excited about this, we'll smash the like button. Smash the like button will help the video reach other people in many different ways. And remember to like the video, 4 likes only until further notice. Watch the morning video for explanation. Birthdays, anniversaries, and prayer requests in the comment section below. And what do you think the meaning of life is? Before we get into this, is just this Kenneth Peterson. It's just his perspective of the meaning of life. What is your meaning of life? I know what the true meaning of life is. God. You've already probably got to guess that one. But subscribe if you're new, turn on notifications, share the video and channel with your family and friends, and help me reach that 30 subscriber mark by January 1st, which is 19 days away. So, and if we hit 30 before the 1st, we go to 50 by Valentine's Day, and if not, March 1st. And then one thing I want, April the 18th is my birthday. And I would like to have one birthday wish granted. And that is 100 subscribers by then. So if you'll do that one thing for me, I will appreciate you more than you can ever imagine. So without further ado, let's hear about the meaning of life from Kenneth Peterson. He writes, a short story by Argentine writer George Luis Borges, and his name is spelled J-O-R-J-E-G-E, George, and it's pronounced George, because I have a newscaster, he's since moved on to Atlanta, but his name is George, and it's spelled that way, but we've always, all the time, had him, and then there was a George. A regular G-E-O-R-G-E, George, a weatherman, and was like, George and George. And this is the way you say it, but it's spelled differently. But it was like Channel 9 out of Orlando. So, but he's since moved on to Atlanta, so. But the name is spelled J-O-R-G-E, George Louis L-U-I-S, Borges, B-O-R-G-E-S. And it tells of a Roman, this short story tells of a Roman soldier, Marcus Rufus, M-A-R-C-U-S, R-U-F-U-S, who drinks from a secret river that purifies men of death. So in time, though, Marcus realizes immortality wasn't all it was cracked up to be. Life without limits was life without significance. In fact, it is death itself that gives meaning to life. You can't have life without death. Marcus finds an antidote, a spring of clear water. After drinking from it, he scratches his hand on a thorn, and a drop of blood forms, signifying his restored mortality, even if that was real. And like stories, they're made up. So like Marcus, we too sometimes despair over the decline of life and the prospect of death, Psalm 88, verse 3. We agree that death gives significance to life, but this is where the stories diverge. Unlike Marcus, we know it's in Christ's death that we find the true meaning of our lives. With the shedding of his blood on the cross, Christ conquered death, swallowing up in victory. 1 Corinthians 15:54. Death has been swallowed up in victory. For us, the antidote is in the living water of Jesus Christ, John 4, verse 10. Because we drink that, all the rules of life, death, and life immortal have changed. 1 Corinthians 15:52. So it's true, we won't escape physical death, but that isn't the point. It's not. It's not the fact that we're going to die, but it's our souls will live on. Our physical bodies may die, but our spirit will live on. And we will all receive a new body when come time for it. Jesus upends all our despair about life and death. Hebrews 2:11-15. So in Christ, we're reassured with the hope of heaven and a meaningful joy in eternal life with him. So what are you worried about? What are your thoughts about the prospect of death? How does 1 Corinthians 15 encourage you? Well, there's three questions today. Okay, so put your responses in there as Q1, Q2, or just make sure you put those beginning of your response so you know which one you're responding to. And then ponder those questions by saying this phrase, which should be on the bottom of the screen. So make sure your subtitles are on to see them. And if you, by chance, don't see it, check the description. But say, God, help me to embrace your promises about deliverance into eternal life with you. That's a little short one there. So hopefully that was there. What your Bible reading today is Hosea 12:13-14, and Revelation chapter 4. Picking them up and putting them down now. Boom, boom, boom. And then the turning point will be, we won't hit it till the 26th Revelation. So we should diverge, the two books should diverge with Revelation by then. So let me see the 26th. The day after Christmas is when we start on Revelation. So we'll be in Revelation 17 on the 26th. 18, 19, 20, 21, and then 22 on the 31st, which we'll be reading 21 and 22 on that last weekend episode of December. So they don't diverge. Well, they do right at the last day. So, but coming up tomorrow in your glorious Hope Day Wednesday, December 14th, 2022, part 2 of episode 931, we will be learning about being in his hands. From Mike Whitmer, derived from Job 38:4-21. So hopefully I have recorded that one on Sunday and it'll be there tomorrow after 1. So with that said, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God, and he'll keep you safe and all you say and do in 2022 and beyond. And until later, peace out, everybody. So long, farewell. Come back later after 7, and we'll be talking about Slowing Down Christmas, episode 419. Beginning with Habakkuk 2:20 from the AMP, which I'll be reading my version to compare it. Our recommended reading is Psalm 46. Psalm chapter 46. Our turning point is from Sandy Heckman. S-A-N-D-I-E, Sandy, H-E-C-K-M-A-N, Heckman. And then we'll be reading the book of 2 Thessalonians, chapters 1, 2, and 3. The only three chapters that book has. So, stay tuned for that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes, but you'll see that later after 7. So, with that said, God bless everyone, and I'll see you later. Have a great rest of your Tuesday afternoon, and come back later after 7 for Slowing Down Christmas. But until then, me and Santa Grogu, we out. Goodbye.